So we were discussing class 500 stitches. In class 500 stitches, we have discussed that they are called overhead, safety or serger stitch because of the functions that they are performing. They are called safety stitch because one group of the thread passes through the loop of the passes through the edge of the material, resulting in edge finishing or neatening of the edge, preventing the particularly the knitted fabrics from reveling. So that is why they are called safety stitches. And then we were discussing that why they are called serger stitches, because serging process can be carried out with the help of these stitches. What is serging is where the raw edge of the fabric can be finished when these loops will be covering the fabric edge and preventing it from the threads being pulled out or preventing it from reveling. And this stitch type and the subclasses generally find application for the knitted fabrics and knitted garments. So stitch type 504 uses one needle and two looper threads. It is highly extensible and a secure stitch, which is used for knitted garments for sweater seams. Then stitch type 515 and 516 are other subtypes of the class 500. So these are referred to as the safety stitches. You can see the diagram here. So this is representing the 515 subclassification of class 500. And these two red color threads are indicating the two needle threads, and these are indicating the looper threads. So this stitch is basically called safety stitch, and it is combination of stitch 401 chain stitch and overhead stitch. So the reason why I have shown this 401 stitches here, if you closely examine this stitch, you will see that the needle thread along with the looper thread here, it is giving the same appearance as 401 that we just discussed, where we will be having this appearance on the face side and a double chain on the back side. So class 515 is a combination of stitch which is formed by 401 and overhead stitch. Overhead stitch, like we saw here, 503. This is one needle thread and the looper thread, and the needle thread is covering the edge of the material. So if you see this lower diagram, it is showing one needle thread, the yellow one, the looper thread, the needle thread is covering the edge of the fabric. So a combination of this over edge, that is 503 and 401 and combination of over edge stitch together, it forms 515 subclassification of class 500, which will be using two needle threads and two looper threads. That means two needles and two loopers will be used for the formation of this stitch. And it is generally used in the manufacturing of shirts, jackets, blouses and jeans. Now last but not the least is class 600, which is also known as cover seam chain stitch. This stitch is known for its strength, for its stretchability, and this stitch is also generally used for knitted fabrics and garments. If you see, this is showing the appearance of the subclass 602 on the face and the back side of the stitch. This stitch is characterized by the use of the top and the bottom covering threads. So this yellow portion is representing the looper thread, which is covering the needle threads on the bottom portion, and this purple one is showing the top covering thread, which is covering the two needle threads on the top. So this purple one is known as the top covering thread, and the bottom one is the yellow one is known as the bottom covering thread. So here you can see that this stitch uses two needles, as indicated by these two red colored threads, and two loopers for the formation of this stitch. Now, what resemblance this 602 has with 406 stitch? If you remember, we just discussed class 406, where we discussed that this stitch is formed with the help of two needles and one looper, and the needle loops are secured by interlooping and interlacement of the looper thread. So there we discussed that the looper thread is serving as the bottom covering thread. And if you remember, we also discussed that class 406 is also known as the bottom covering chain stitch because of this bottom thread, which which was the looper thread, which was covering the needle thread in this way. So a close examination of this diagram will show that if this purple part is eliminated and if you see the red and the yellow portion, so this stitch is exactly similar to 406. So what is additional in class 602 is this top covering thread, which has been introduced with the help of another looper. So this is the difference between class 602 and 406, that 406 will be made using a bottom covering thread or only one looper, and when a top covering thread using another looper is introduced, so that stitch type is called class 602. So this will be more extensible, it will be consuming more thread compared to class 406. So this is giving the description of how the thread is formed, how the stitch is formed. So two group of threads cover both the surface of the material. So these group of threads will be covering both surface of the material. Loop of first group of thread, that is needle thread, are passed through the loops of the third group already on the surface of material. So here the third group is being referred to this top covering thread. So this top covering thread will appear on the face side of the fabric, and the needle loops will be secured by this top covering thread on the face side of the material, and then through the material where they are outer loop with loops of second group of thread on the underside of the material, and the needle threads will be interlooping with the second group of the thread. The second group of thread here is the looper thread, this yellow one, on the underside of the material. So the needle threads are being secured on the face side of material with this top covering thread, which is the purple one, and on the underside they are secured by means of this looper thread, which is yellow in color shown here. So where they are outer loop with loops of second group of thread on the underside of the material. So here the second group of thread is being referred to the looper thread. The third group is referred to this purple one, the top covering thread, and the needle thread is represented by these two red colored threads. The second group of thread is known as top covering thread. This is the second group, which is the top covering thread, which is covering the needle thread on the top side of the material. And the third group is known as the bottom covering thread. This is the third group, which is the bottom covering thread, which is securing the needle loops on the bottom side of the material. These stitches are strong, elastic, and are used on knitted garments to cover the raw edges to prevent the reveling. And these are also used for attachment of ribbed knit collars on knitted garments. So far we have discussed the different stitch classes. So these all classes of stitches belong to the stitches which are produced on machine. Machine stitches are more complicated to make, but of course the production time is less. They consume less time as compared to hand stitches. So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing the distinguishing factors or the differences between hand stitches and the machine stitches. So that is all for today. Thank you.